Hi. Hey, I was wondering if I could take some time just to explain a little bit about the context for the book of Joshua. You know, it almost is a courageous move for us as a church to anchor this series on the book of Joshua, especially in this day and age. You know, it's a book about war, and religious war is not exactly a really safe topic nowadays. But here's the thing about the Bible. The Bible intends to just tell things as they are in the environment that it is. The book of Joshua is a historical book, so it doesn't mince any of, it doesn't pull back any punches when it describes the kind of world and era of that period, maybe 4,000 years ago. We today will have a lot of problems with some of the violence and destruction and killing that goes on in the book of Joshua. But I want to put it to you that in the time that it was written, it was very accurately portraying the culture that was there. And God had to speak into a fallen, kind of corrupt world that was in that time and place. We're dealing with a very brutal world. And so here, I'm hoping this session will help you as a little bit of an aside to grapple with the fact that we have a very brutal God described in the book of Joshua. Firstly, you need to understand that God is the same God in the Old Testament and in the New Testament. And we are not talking about two different gods, a really nice, fluffy God in the New Testament who's full of love and a real mean God in the Old Testament. It's the same God. But the Bible, you have to remember, is a book that's been written. It's actually a collection of books that's been written over thousands of years. And so some of the books that are in the Old Testament, they're written in that era by people of that era, talking about just the real things that went on in that era. You have to understand that every reader in the BC days before Jesus came, as they would read these holy texts, they would not be fazed at all. None of them were stumbled by the degree of violence and killing that goes on in the book of Joshua. In fact, most of them were serving other gods who were way more brutal. This was the way cities were conquered. This was the way, I'm so glad that humanity has grown. A large part of it, actually, in the Western world has been due to Christianity. Has been grown to be a much more civilized society where we value human life much more. But back in that day, when the setting of this book, this was just the way it is. And I'm glad that Joshua doesn't pull any punches. The other thing that is a big sort of, could be a big of a problem in dealing with the book of Joshua is how come the God of the Bible can be so evil and cruel, you know, killing entire families. And you know, did we just go into a place that has, incumbent people in there and just kick them out, saying that this is my promised land? How could there be this God? And I just want to put it to you that there are often comparisons made about our God not being a good God. But you have to remember that if there was no God, the world we lived in, if there was no God, and so there was just the God of nature, let's say, you know, and the world is what it is, evolution or whatever, that the God of nature herself is also a brutal God. Killing species, killing people willy-nilly for no good and entire continents being wiped out, species becoming extinct, families being killed. In fact, the world we live in is a brutal world, and it doesn't help anyone for us to think that everything is always nice and fluffy. And God is different from that. He engages with a brutal world and has a redemption plan and has hope for us after this fallen world that we live in. In fact, after Jesus Christ, which is why the New Testament is so different from the Old Testament, after Jesus Christ comes an era of unprecedented grace. Jesus bears the brunt of all the violence and brutality that is deserving from sin, and then opens us up into the loving arms of our Father. So it's not that the world has become less brutal. It's that Jesus has taken our place. We need to remember that, you know, we have the same God, and He is brutal against sin, but He is also unmatchable in His love. If we don't see sin as really bad and brutal and violent, then we'll never really comprehend how much love God has for us. Please remember as we do this, that the point of the book of Joshua is to steer us away from sin. You know, in Matthew, Jesus even says, talks about cutting off your eye and your arm because that is the effect that sin could have. God had to be very brutal, you know, even with Achan and I, about sin, because it has this potential to completely derail us and remove us from God, to wreck our lives. In fact, the end of sin is death. So I hope this kind of helps you process the book of Joshua. Really, we'd love to talk to you about it. If you've got any questions, you can email me at chris.ong@fgam.org.au, and I'd love to talk to you about it. But please remember that this is a book not written in today's setting, but having application for today. God bless.